Hello friends, in this tutorial I will demonstrate how you can load tally data into MySQL database server using a free and open source utility developed by me. I have arranged my setup in a fashion that my tally is on one machine, database server is on a cloud based machine, and I will be accessing this data from another remote machine via internet. Also, this time for a change, my tally will be running not on a Windows based OS but on a Linux machine. So please check it out. I am using Ubuntu Desktop, which is a graphical variant of Linux. It is free and it has many features like Windows, and you can see even Tally Prime is also installed in it. So that is the interesting part. Now let us see how do we install the utility first inside it. So I'll open my Firefox browser and go to my utility homepage. So don't worry, in the video description you will find its link. Okay, so first we need to download and install Node.js. Now in my PC, see, it is already installed. So you can click here, download the install. So on download, you will find a .deb file downloaded. So you can just install it. Okay. Now on the database portion, I will be using MySQL server, and this MySQL server, I am not running in this operating system. So I have, now let me show you. So I have gone to Oracle Cloud, and in the free tier, okay, you get a operating system, one Linux server with 1 GB RAM and small 10 GB hard disk, and it is free. So I created one Linux server on the Oracle Cloud. So you can also sign up with the free version. Okay, and it has, see, the trial has ended, and I'm running it in the free version with many limitations. Okay, so now configuring this Linux server and installing MySQL server on that, it is a very technical. So I would not go through this because our intention is not to show that, but to show the utility. Okay, now let us download the utility. Okay, so first I will open a folder for the utility. So I'll go to downloads folder, and let us open a new folder for the utility. Let's name it utility. Okay, and in this utility we will download the So download database loader utility. Let's click here. Okay, save as, and okay, so it is downloaded. Let us check. So you will find this in downloads folder. Okay, let me move this zip file inside the utility, and let us extract it. Okay, so I will click extract here, so that, okay, I'll cut paste this files means here. Okay, and download this extra folders. Okay, so inside your utility you will find this many files, so same files which we saw in Windows. Now first let me tell you the same process you can also do in Windows also. Just for a change, I am showing it in Linux so that you also come to know that there is another piracy free option of doing this. Okay, let us connect to the MySQL server on that Oracle Cloud Linux machine. So you will need to download any tool for connecting to MySQL. So generally you will find here. Okay, so I am using MySQL Workbench, which is free of cost. So I already installed it. So you get this for Windows and Linux both. Okay, so I will connect to this Oracle My Cloud. I have configured the connection, so I'll just click here and connect it. Okay, so first let us create the database. So if I right click here and click create schema, I can create the database. So let us name the database, let's say TallyDB, and let us click apply. So the database was created and you can see this. Now we will create structure of the database. So you will find in the utility folder a file called database structure.sql. So let us open this file using MySQL Workbench. So I'll go to file, okay, open SQL script and let us browse it. So in downloads, utility, database structure.sql. Okay, so let us first double click TallyDB so that we select this database as a target database, and control A, I will select all the statements, SQL statement, and I will click execute. Okay, query completed. Let us refresh so that we can see all the tables. See, all the tables have been created. So friends, this way you can create a structure of the database. Okay, and make sure you are password protecting your Linux server with a good password. Okay, so I'll now close this connection. Let us open our Tally and configure the XML server of it. So I will double click on Tally Prime and run it. Now this is the beauty that on the Linux Windows software is running Tally Prime. Okay, now if you want to know how you means run, okay, let me select the company. So if you want to know that how I have done this, okay, there is a software called WineHQ. Okay, it is an emulator for Windows application. So in Linux, you'll find how to install it and the steps. So if you install this, you can run all the Windows software, like even MS Office you can run. Okay, so let me go to my Tally. See, let me show you in about that how we are in. So this is actually emulating Windows 7. Okay, so Tally doesn't know that which operating system we are using. So emulator has configured Windows 7 internally, but we are not running a complete Windows 7 machine, but just emulating it. And this is my registered version. See, I'm connected to a Tally which license server, which is on there on my Windows machine. Okay, so first we will have to go to help, settings, connectivity. Okay, now my Tally is configured on port number 9000 by default, so I'll keep that only, and your Tally should be acting as both. Okay, so our Tally XML server is running perfectly. Now we will configure the utility. So again, this is a one time. Okay, so you will find a file called config.json. Just right click it and open it with text editor. Okay, any, you know, Linux has by default text editor. Okay, in technology I will write MySQL server, MySQL. Okay, server, now our database server is in IP address. I'll have to copy paste. Okay, we'll copy paste this whatever IP address is configured. Control C and I will paste that IP address here. Okay, MySQL runs on port number 3306. You will also find this on in the documentation. Schema name, I created it my name TallyDB only. Okay, username by default in MySQL username is generally root. Okay, and password, I would be hiding the password due to secrecy, so we'll see blurred thing. Okay, I will write down my password, whatever password you have configured when you are installing MySQL server. Okay, load method is would be insert, and on where our Tally is running. Now Tally is running on this our Linux desktop only. Okay, port number 9000 correct, master transaction true, batch full, and from date to date. Okay, you have to write it in reverse format, year, month, and day, and it should be 8 digits. Okay, let us save this file. So our configuration is ready, and let me close this file now. since we have configured everything, so let us run the utility. So you will have to right click and launch the terminal, because that we would be requiring command prompt to run this. Okay, so it would start in this folder. Okay, and you have to write node space dot slash means the same folder, and inside dist folder there is a file called index.js. So run a file called index.js in dist folder. So let us press enter and the utility will start running. Okay, so let us wait until the utility ends and our import end. Okay, so utility has successfully run. So let me exit the command prompt and check our error and import log. So let me open with import log. Okay, so all the data, see, all the rows were imported into this Oracle based my server. Okay, or whatever server you have configured. Let us check if there were any error. No errors. Okay, so our data got imported. Let us verify our data. So I will again go to that MySQL workbench, connect to my virtual machine. Okay, I will close this database structure file. So let us check our ledger table. So I will write query select star from MST ledger. Okay, and select it and execute it. Okay, so you can see the ledger. So our data got imported successfully on our MySQL server. Friends, now I would be accessing that MySQL database of cloud using some my Windows machine from a remote location via Excel. Okay, so let me start Excel. Okay, now first let us copy paste the IP address of your cloud-based machine, whatever IP address in your case might be. Then we will go to data, get data from other sources from ODBC. Okay, now you need to install MySQL connector clients. Okay, client connector. So if you want to access MySQL data from any of the servers. Okay, I will choose MySQL and go to advanced option, and here in connection you have to write driver is equal to in angular braces MySQL space ODBC 8.0 Unicode driver semicolon server is equal to whatever IP address in your case might be semicolon database, whatever database name. Okay, we had configured database by name TallyDB. Okay, so let us click OK and attempt to connect it. Okay, so it would be asking username and password of MySQL server. So username generally is root by default, and password, whatever password it might be. Let me enter my password. Okay, so and I will click connect. Okay, so it has got permission. Let me connect to the TallyDB database and I will try to load ledger table from it. Okay, let us click load so that the data get loaded into the Excel. Since it is over the web, so it might be a bit slow. So friends, we are successfully able to connect from our cloud-based server to Excel. So the beauty of this is that your Tally might be in different machine, your database server is in some different machine, and you can access this data from anywhere, literally anywhere. Friends, let me remove a confusion. It is not necessary that your MySQL database server should be on a cloud-based machine on a Linux server. you can install it even on Windows 10 machine on the same PC. Also, utilities cross-platform, so it can run on Windows, Linux, or even on your MacBook also. So please try this, and please like the video and subscribe to the Excel Kida channel for the future updates.